Hello and greetings from Iceland, but it's time to talk about the situation in Grindavík. But as many of you might already know, the seismic activity has been decreasing fast and the land uplift has stopped. But that won't last for long, according to our experts. So I do have some information to work with today, like the lava barriers they are planning there. But first, I want to mention the volcano Hekla, but the live feed from the seismometers was a bit confusing for a little while last night. So I literally exploded up from the sofa as I noticed a magnitude 4 earthquake after a few earthquakes at very little depth on this huge volcano that's very much ready for an eruption. And lots of things rushed through my mind in just a matter of seconds. Like, are all my drone batteries fully charged? Do I need to transfer something from my memory cards before I format them for the trip? But worst of all, I remembered this last trip of mine back south, where I didn't go up to Mount Hekla, because instead I used the road by the plate boundaries on the way up north, wasting my time for this. So after some running around like a headless chicken, I managed to concentrate again, only to find out that this magnitude 4 earthquake was at a different location and later on downgraded to magnitude 3. So this was just a rehearsal. But Hekla is a volcano that gives us very little or no warning at all. Just some earthquakes for like 30 minutes and off she goes. So anyway, I'm using the chance now to link again to the live cams, although this turned out to be a homemade false alarm this time. But back to Grindavík, and our experts say it's not over, and actually just starting. So Mother Earth is just taking a deep breath before she continues to pump up magma, and that would be for the fifth time. But then, the earthquake activity just picked up a bit yesterday, so we can't really say that the fourth chapter is over. But we did, however, learn that our experts have located the dike in the making, and from there I will talk about the lava barriers. So we start on a map, and here it is. This is where the magma is squeezing its way through the crust, and the location is no surprise, and the location is awful. But map is just a map, so let's fly around to give you a better sense of the landscape. And my first takeoff is here, or where this intrusion dike runs straight under this lava field called Svartsengi, where we have this power plant, or midst between the power plant and Mount Thorbjörn. So we are directly above it now, and the dike stretches all the way up to this mountain called Sílingafell. And below us we have some of the steam pipes that lead to a power plant. But let's move back to get a bigger picture, and then we get this. The dike is here, then we have Grindavík, the power plant, and the Blue Lagoon. And this is getting a bit clearer now since the dike has been located, but we do still face a lot of problems. Or like one expert just mentioned, it doesn't have to come up there. But the dike does, however, line up in the classic south-west-northeast fissure swarm direction. So one would think that it's more likely to see an eruption come up along the dike, or where the land is already very broken, rather than to see it move closer to town. And we don't have that many vents around the town. But this is getting so serious now that the government is now working on things like they are expecting an eruption soon. So we are back to the lava barriers that I mentioned a while ago. And barriers have not been formally suggested to the government, but the final decision will most likely be up to the science board of the Civil Defense Agency. So back to the map, the plans have not been made public yet, so all we know is that they mentioned important infrastructure, and that's of course the power plant, but the thing is that we just don't know yet from where the threat comes. It's all just a guessing game, and the only solution would be to close off the power plant with huge barriers, and the only protection that the nature supplies us with around there is Mount Thorbjörn. The rest of the gravel would have to be trucked there, and a lot of it. And as you look at the map with an earthquake layer on top of it for the last 7 days, but the red dots are the most recent earthquakes, we see that one of the pressure points is actually by the roots of Mount Thorbjörn. So let's look at it from this angle now. The earthquakes by Mount Thorbjörn are extremely close by the power plant, and we are flying almost directly over the dike again. And the power plant sits in this little depression in the land, and the Blue Lagoon is not in any better situation. Perhaps a bit better off, but not much though, And I don't see it coming that they will build these huge gravel walls in front of the windows of this five-star hotel down there. They could just as well close it. And I don't see what can be done to protect the power plant. It would be a huge construction to secure it from all sides. And I just don't see that coming. But let's talk about the town now. An eruption near the power plant would perhaps not be the worst case scenario. And it would need to produce a huge amount of lava in order for it to move into town. And there are only two routes possible. First, this mountain pass, but it's up on a hill. So I see it as highly unlikely. But the other route would be at this side of Mount Thorbjörn, where we have some old craters that made those natural barriers that could buy us some time. But still, a huge volume of lava could bypass this ridge and put the westernmost part of town at risk. But I do think though that we could be able to control the flow a bit around there. But at least I can say that this is not the worst case scenario for a town. So back to the map with the earthquakes. I have been talking about the Sundanhuka row of craters since before the Geldingadalir eruption started last year. And the most recent earthquakes take place along that nasty old fissure. And there we have a whole new scenario for the civil defense to work from. It could be just a matter of meters from where the eruption would come up if the lava would flow down to the power plant. But at least it's easier to protect it from that side only. But due to how it's located, it would only hold for so long. And the same goes for the town. But at this moment, the earthquakes are mostly at the northern part of this enormous fissure swarm. And we already got a warning about the potential eruption further to the northeast, which I covered in a recent video. So to have this moving north is not bad. And as we turn to the town, we see why. And it's a good time now to remind you about a 20-minute long video I just made that covers the fissure that runs through this town and the complete story, and I'm linking to it. But it's not good to see this little cluster of earthquakes now just under the northernmost houses in town. And even though I'm not the expert, it's easy to see that this might just be our biggest threat, given that the eruption comes up near the old craters. So, can we protect the town? But the absolutely worst case scenario is a harbor, no town. So some planning was done last year during the Geldingadalir eruption, but they decided to hold on with the making of barriers back then. But it's up on the table now, so let's see what they are dealing with. And here we have a photo from the south. Again, we see the Sundanhukar row of craters, and my guess is that the only available solution is to try to direct the lava from up there into this little bay and sacrifice the farms there in order to protect the town and the harbor. And here we are a bit closer, but the thing is that this old row of craters is just so long, and if we would get an eruption at the southwest end of it, it's only 800 meters from the northernmost houses in town, and from a such scenario, it's more or less nothing that we could do. But at least it's good that the action is up there, mostly at the other end of the fissure swarm. So there is always this possibility that the lava would take this old path or even to the north, which would be excellent. So let's move up there and look back. This house sits up on a little hill, and from there it might be possible to make a barrier to control the lava to the east from the town, or as it looks to me from here. But I have to admit that for this kind of work, I would need to do another flyover with a fixed altitude setting on a drone, just a little above the highest ground, and fly low to get more 3D sense of the landscape. So that is what I will do in my next trip south. But first, I want to finish some videos for the tourist part of my channel. And I'm also making a video about the North Iceland seismic zone that I want to get online soon. But it is a priority now for me to do a Hekla flyover. And I've already picked the takeoff locations since a drone has its limitations when it comes to range. So I will be documenting a landscape that simply might not be there in just a few years. And the same goes for Grindavík. And I have to admit that things don't look good for the town. And even worse for the power plant and the Blue Lagoon. And then we have all this land uplift nearby or under the Krýsuvík volcanic system. A large earthquake awaits us near Reykjavík, and I still think it's a reason to keep an eye on Hekla and the complete South Iceland seismic zone. But there are some strange earthquakes there now, or more tension than usual. It will most likely fade out, of course, but those are just so strange times now, or the strangest times that my generation has seen when it comes to the geology of Iceland. But on the positive side, this is also unique chance to see Mother Earth in the making, and all the features of the landscape in Iceland that can hardly be seen elsewhere. So while I'm not covering Volcano news, I will be showing you something special. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.